What is the file picker? In this video, we're going to explore Moodle's file picker and how you can use it. You might see the file picker if you upload a file using the activity chooser, or if you're in the editor and want to add an image through the image icon, or a media file such as sound or video, or if you click the H5P icon to upload an H5P file. If we click to add a file, on the next screen when we go to the Select Files area, we can access the file picker by clicking the Add button. What you see on the left side are links which are called repositories, and each of these are places where you can retrieve files to display on your course. The one you'll use most often is Upload a File. This will allow you to access your documents from your computer or USB drive. The Content Bank is where you retrieve H5P interactive content made or uploaded to the Content Bank from Course Navigation, More. Server files are files in other courses which you have access to as a teacher. So for instance, if you're teaching Grade 1 English in one course and you wanted to add a file that you had used in Grade 2 English, a different course, you go to Server Files to locate it. Recent files shows you the last few files that you've uploaded, and it is context sensitive. This means that Moodle knows if you want to upload an image through the image icon, it will only show you images. If you want to upload a sound file using the media icon, it will only show you media files. Private files allows you to retrieve files you have previously uploaded into your personal private file storage area, which we look at in a separate video. URL Downloader allows you to add a web page and it will download for you the images from that web page. Other links or repositories will appear according to what your administrator has enabled. So here, for example, you can go to Wikimedia if you wanted to find an image which you could search for with a particular size, or Google Drive or OneDrive, as here. The files in the file picker can be displayed in three different ways. And if we click Recent Files, you can see how this works. If you look on the far right, files are displayed like a tree. The middle button displays them with details of their size, type, when they were last modified. And the third button on the left shows them as icons displaying what type file they are. So for instance, we can easily see that this is a PowerPoint presentation and these are Word files.